This is Sergio Canavero, an Italian neurosurgeon who has announced plans to transplant an entire human head onto a different human body at the end of 2017. Yep. So whole head transplant. How possible is this? Why hasn't it been done before? And maybe most importantly, why are people calling this guy crazy? Unlike other organs, your brain and spinal cord are extremely sensitive to damage and resistant to repair. This is why injury to the neck or spine often results in permanent injury, and complete reattachment of heads severed from their bodies has remained the stuff of science fiction and fantasy. That isn't to say that scientists aren't working diligently to develop techniques to aid in spinal cord repair. Current approaches include stem cell therapies that encourage growth of new neurons, and biological glues that work like electrical tape to patch severed fibers back together. But these approaches are far from helping patients fully recover after trauma. And if we could do that, it would be a sensational step forward in the field of medical science. Which brings us back to Sergio Canavero and his plans to transplant an entire human head. The procedure proposed by Canavero and his team requires cooling of both the donor head and the recipient body to increase the amount of time both can survive without blood circulation. Next, the major blood vessels in the neck would be dissected and reconnected. Then once the head is moved over, the neuronal fibers of the spinal cord would be fused and the blood vesicles and muscles would be sewn together. The new patient would be kept in a coma for several weeks for recovery, and electrodes would be used to electrically stimulate the nerve fibers to encourage connections. But who would he be when he woke up? As a neuroscientist, I'm incredibly excited about what head transplants could teach us about consciousness, identity, and the brain's conception of the self. Not to mention the millions of patients whose lives would be changed by improving techniques for spinal cord repair. But I have some questions. Mainly, why do we think we can do this, and should we? Canavero and his Chinese collaborator, Chaoping Ren, have been reporting progress on development of head transplantation techniques to journalists and the media for several years. They've claimed progress in transplant and spinal cord repair in rodents, dogs, and primates. But only their work on rodents has been accepted and published by scientifically credible sources. The scientific community in general likes careful, validated, incremental progress. And every time Canavero and his team announce a result via press release instead of peer-reviewed journal, the claim is met with skepticism and disbelief. This is in part due to poor scientific technique in their experimental design, small sample size, poor controls, and limited data on patient outcomes. Their approach of bypassing peer review and the opinions of experts in favor of media coverage, and the fact that no other surgical team has yet reproduced their results. If scientific understanding is to move forward, we cannot refuse to try new things on the basis that we've never done it before. And it's my belief that the scientific community would be thrilled to accept a more conservative approach, driven by multiple successes in animal models and less dramatic spinal cord repair in humans, before attempting to transplant a whole human head. But that leaves the question of whether we should be transplanting heads at all. In 2015, when Canavero first announced his plan for a whole head transplant of a human patient, an article in Newsweek quoted then-president-elect of the American Association for Neurological Surgeons as saying, "I would not wish this on anyone. I would not allow anyone to do it to me, as there are a lot of things worse than death." Special thanks to our sponsor, Domain.com. When you buy a domain name from Domain.com, you're taking the first step in creating an identity and a vision for your brand. No domain extension will help tell your story like a .com or a .net domain name, and get 15% off Domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use the coupon code SEEKER at checkout. Okay, so head transplants might be a little ways away, but organ transplants aren't. Doctors do them all the time. But what happens to your body after you donate your organs? Find out in this video here. Would you sign up for a head transplant without knowing how it could affect humans? Let us know in the comments, like this video, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.